Since in Argentina you eat late, apparently. It's midnight. We're gonna go find food because apparently that's the norm here at this time. So let's see if we find anything open still. Way from Palermo, Buenos Aires. We woke up a little later today since we did arrive so late, but from what I've seen, it is so pretty here. We have an Airbnb with a little balcony, and you can just see people walking by and enjoying their lives. So we're gonna go eat. We're always eating, and we're gonna see how we can get more towards the downtown area because we're in Palermo, which is more on the east side of the city, west side of the city, my bad. We're out and about and I got my first empanada on my trip, and it is fantastic. So we're going to Plaza Mayo, to the downtown area. Casa Rosada, the cathedral, Metropolitan Cathedral, Banco de la Nación, just many beautiful landscapes around. It's crazy. So where we're at is like right off of the Casa Rosada, as you can see behind me. We have really important buildings around us, but then there's a huge shift of this architecture right back here, which is like very French inspired to something a little more modern, like that. There's a whole skyline, and then there's even more over there, so very cool contrast. Reached Puerto Madero, which is a port here in Argentina, and I'm actually not really sure what there is around here, but I know there's for sure a lot of hotels and restaurants and lots of American chain restaurants that you would see in the US. El Puente de la Mujer, Puerto Madero, all around us. This is my poke bowl, my roll. She got the same. Good morning. It's the next day in Buenos Aires, and we are heading over to the bus to get on it to go to La Boca. Alright, we have arrived at La Boca, and I just saw people dancing tango right outside of the restaurant, so we're gonna go eat our first meal of today at La Perla del Caminito. So we are at La Boca, and this was created by Italian immigrants here in Argentina in the past, and I actually heard, I don't know if this is true, but I once heard that the buildings are all super colored because they would use the paint that was left over from the ships, so it's just a mix of colors, but it's really nice. It almost feels like a fantasy land, like Disney or something, but La Boca is awesome. Just have a little bit of precaution for security purposes, but you will enjoy what you see here. My gosh, today has been a long but great day. We ended this part of the day, at least at Alto Palermo, which is a shopping center in Palermo where we're staying. But yeah, La Boca was cool. Just be, like I said, precautious of your belongings because somebody almost did their thing on us with my dad's phone. But anyway, we might be staying for tonight. I don't know. We might go out a little more, but at least for now, we're gonna rest. Good morning from the bosques de Palermo. We're waiting for the Buenos Aires bus to explore the city from a couple decades. So let's get some coffee before from Havana. I loved it yesterday. I have my Havana. I got a dulce leche latte. This is seriously like in the top three best coffees I've had in my life. So if you're in Buenos Aires, you have to try the latte from Havana. Thank you. right, so today we went on the Buenos Aires bus, which is a really good option. It's like $20, you can get on and off as many times as you want. But we went around the city in that, and then we went to eat, and we went to many different places throughout the day. So it was really nice, it was cool, but now we're home and a little bit sleepy. So tomorrow we're gonna be on that bus again, and hopefully maybe go to the Recoleta cemetery, maybe go to Evita Perron's house and some other cool stuff around. We'll see. But anyway, that's it for tonight. I'll see you guys tomorrow morning. Good morning. So today we came to La Recoleta, to the cemetery, and it's raining, so it is such a dramatic day and perfect time to see the cemetery like that. So this area here is interesting because in Buenos Aires you have a lot of French architecture, but here there's a lot of Spanish influenced architecture, so it feels different. It feels more like the rest of Latin America does. So we're entering the cemetery area now. This is Evita Perón's tomb. It's crazy. The story of Eva's tomb is really interesting to me because she died, I think, in the 30s or 40s, maybe 50s, I'm probably super wrong. But anyway, she was buried, I'm assuming, in this tomb right behind me, and her body got stolen, and it was all around Buenos Aires, Argentina, for who knows how long. I think it was like 20 and 30 years, and they had to find her body again, reconstruct it, do another viewing for it, and then now she's stored in there forever. So it's just crazy to see that that can happen to such a prominent figure. Anyway, that's Evita Perón's tomb. So for some reason, these cats live here at La Recoleta. It's crazy, they just live here on their own. The cemetery, and if you come to Buenos Aires and you don't go there, I think you didn't go to Buenos Aires. It is one of those places that you have to go to. So, La Recoleta again, awesome, recommended. Good morning, all the way from Buenos Aires, Argentina. I'm so excited because today we're going to Montevideo, Uruguay. I've never been there before. I'm going to be there for the day today. And I'm so excited to see this country that I've heard such great stuff about. So let's go. Let's start our day with some yerba mate. I really don't know what this park is called, but it's beautiful. If you're in Montevideo, you need to come look at it because there's so many trees. And especially right now during fall, it's just so, so, so nice. Right now we're going into the cathedral. I don't know what the name of it is, but we're gonna go check it out and then go on the Turibus, the two-level bus here, so we can explore the city from up top. Right, so I feel so uneducated, sorry, but I found out that it is the Catedral Metropolitana de Montevideo. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Take some time to go look at it because it's so nice. That was an extensive tour of Montevideo. I feel like I saw a lot, thankfully. But now we're at the port, looking for some coffee, probably, and just exploring the old town because it's actually really nice from what I can see. It looks charming. It reminds me of Panama, actually. So we might explore around here for an hour until we leave back to Buenos Aires. Was old town. It's small. I feel like it's gonna get developed in the next few years for some reason, and it's gonna be super, super awesome to come back to one day. But back to the ship to go back to Buenos Aires. So that was my day in Montevideo. I had a really good time. It was cool getting to see a new country that I expected to be one way and was totally a different way, but that's the cool thing about traveling. So, see you guys back in Argentina. Good morning. It is raining a lot and it's really chilly today. But with a sweater and a coat on top, you will be fine. So we're going to Carlos Gardel's house, a very famous tango singer, and then we're going to continue at a few more museums and then a market. And as you can see, there's a lot of painting around here, lots of artsy houses, and it feels very boho, very Bohemian. So I like it already. We're gonna go to the museum. I heard it's small but very nice, and I'm excited to see the house of one of my favorite museums.
So this museum is really cool because you can take self-guided tours. They'll give you headphones and you can log on to their server and you can use that to go throughout the whole museum and kind of get to know a little bit more of Guide Los Gardens history. I think it's a really, really good museum to go to. So the Mercado San Telmo is one of my biggest recommendations, especially if you're looking for decently priced souvenirs that are really hip and like more modern. I got some really cool art pieces here for really cheap, so I recommend it. You'll also be able to find really good dulce de leche and some awesome choripan and different types of food, so please make the trip out to Mercado San Telmo. It's definitely worth it.
Back at the Airbnb, and everything we saw today was great. You guys should check out the Carlos Gardel Museum if you guys like tango at all. And if not, go to San Telmo and go to the San Telmo Market because it is a must. There's so much to do, so much to see, so much to buy also if you're trying to find some antiques. So I loved it. We went back for more sushi today, and tomorrow is our last day in Buenos Aires. So good night and see you guys tomorrow morning. Good morning. It's our last day in Buenos Aires, and today was a historic day in Buenos Aires and actually Argentina history, they said, because the power went out in all of Argentina, Uruguay, Bolivia, Paraguay, Brazil, Chile, and it was like just gone for like 6 hours, gone in Brazil for 2 days. So that cut our morning a bit short, but we're still gonna take advantage of the rest of the day that we have ahead of us and enjoy our last day here. So I think we're gonna go to Churrasqueria, get some of that churrasco on our last day, and then we'll see what the rest of the day has in store for us. On our way back, we're in Bogota for a few hours and we're gonna get some food, some coffee, hopefully see a little bit of this area right here. So welcome to Bogota for a few hours.
So my phone and my camera both died right after this shot. So that's my last footage I have. But just know, South America is awesome. And if you have never been, you should definitely prioritize it. I think it doesn't receive the credit it deserves. But if you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. Give this video a like, comment on your favorite part of my travel vlog. And I hope to see you guys for my next one. Thank you for watching.